Hello, and thanks so much for watching Proactive New York. With me right now is William Trainer, CEO at Grande West Transportation. William, it's great to meet you. How are you?
I'm great, thank you. It's a great morning up here.
That's good to hear. William, kick us off with giving us a brief intro into the company.
Sure, okay. Well, Grande West Transportation is a bus manufacturer. We're headquartered up here in Vancouver, Canada, and we're just doing expansion into the U.S. With a new headquarters in Washington State.
So I understand the company is currently going through a name change from Grande West Transportation to Vicinity Motor Corp. Can you maybe explain the reasoning behind that?
Sure. Yeah, we're going to be doing an uplisting to the Nasdaq, and we just want to have a consolidation in the name just to have it all flow well. Our buses that we produce have the Vicinity line product that's trademarked, and we want to reflect that into the new name change.
And any idea on timing on uplisting to the Nasdaq?
Well, we're rapidly going forward. We need to complete our year-end financial statements, which is one of the requirements. That should be done at the end of March, and then just as quickly as we can apply and get on.
Excellent. So you mentioned kind of your focus on entering the U.S. market. Can you talk more about your strategy there?
Sure. Yeah, we've done, as a Canadian-based company, we've done extremely well in the Canadian market. In the mid-sized buses that we compete in, we have about a 90% market penetration, and we're looking to do that same success in the U.S. We are building a new factory down in Washington State to facilitate the orders that we're going to receive in the United States. And we've done quite a large expansion. We're looking to expand our dealer network, our presence in the market, both on the capital market side and in the reflecting to the customers.
So tell us about this new kind of deal that you formed with the New Mexico state in the U.S. What are the details there?
Well, in the U.S., a lot of the tenders that come out are what they would consider menu bids. So you need to qualify in the state to be able to sell to that that state. We've qualified. We're on that tender, and that's just one of many that we're bidding right now across the country.
Is there a certain goal you have in mind of number of buses you hope to sell in the U.S.?
Sure. We're building a factory in Washington that can accommodate up to 1,000 buses. We certainly like to fill that as quickly as we could.
And how about, looking down the line next few months or so, are there kind of some concrete milestones you can tell investors?
Well, sure. The NASDAQ uplisting is one. We should be opening up our factory in Washington State. We're looking to have that completed by Q3 of this year and in operation by Q4. And just growing our order book. We announce orders as we receive the purchase order. So we're looking forward to having quite a bit of that.
And, clearly there's a huge electric vehicle revolution going on right now. Do you focus mostly on electric buses or kind of runs the gamut here?
Well, no. So I think this is what sets us aside from a lot of competition that's just entering the market with the electric bus. We're an established company. We have good relationships built already for our standard buses, which come in gas, like gasoline, diesel, and CNG. And now with our expansion into the EV side, we're just ready for that growth. The market is moving towards EV, and we want to be prepared for it and capture all of that we can.
Excellent. It was great to learn more about the company. William, thanks so much.
Well, thank you so much.